What's going on there, baby dragon squad? I got another deck profile for you guys here today for the November 2017 Forbidden and Limited list that Konami dropped. Obviously, they hit Spirals pretty hard. They didn't hit this deck, though. I'm a huge fan of Geargia's. It's actually just a very fun, casual deck. It's pretty easy to build for the most part in terms of obviously just being able to get a couple structure decks and putting it together. It's not really a popular deck anymore in the competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! Or even casually for whatever reason. But it's a deck that I really enjoy, and I thought it'd be a cool opportunity to profile it for you guys here today. It's obviously not hit by the list, so we're gonna get into it. This is Geargia's for the latest ban list. I'm not gonna be doing a side deck today. It's a 41 card list, and this is just something I was kind of just messing around with for fun, nothing too serious. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video at the end of it, make sure to slap that like button. If you guys want to see my latest videos, make sure you guys join the Baby Dragon Squad by clicking that notification bell and subscribing if you're new here. I have a giveaway going on. If it hasn't already ended, click that Gleam link down below. And then finally, if you guys want to help the channel grow, make sure you guys become a patron on the Patreon down below. We're going to get into it. Geargia's is a very slow deck. It's a deck that typically plays from behind because it's a very defensive deck. And yeah, so first and foremost, we have three Geargia Augurs. It's one of the only monsters that I probably like the least. This is my least favorite monster in the entire deck. It works when it's summoned. You get to basically net yourself a free Earth Machine type monster from your deck. But the problem is that you can't declare attacks or special summon monsters except machine type monsters for the rest of the turn. So it's not the greatest monster because it can inhibit you a lot. But other than that, it's just another starter card, which you kind of need. We run three Geargia Armors. This is pretty much one of the main focal points of the deck. It's the monster that you pretty much use to flip it face up and face down. Over and over to net yourself free pluses. It has a big booty, and you can basically just keep adding Geargia monsters, just like Augur, except without summoning it. This one just requires a simple flip up. So it's a really cool monster. It's one of my favorite monsters in the entire deck. Same thing with Geargia Arsenal. You basically use Arsenal to tribute itself off to get one of your other Geargia monsters. You usually get armor, and then you use armor's effect to put it back face down. He's a beat stick. Don't forget he does gain 200 attack for each Geargia monster you have, so you can actually make him quite beefy. You can get him up quite big. You can get him, you know, up to 19. You can get him to 21, depending on how many monsters you have on the field. He's really cool. You can actually use him in conjunction with some of the Geargiano monsters, but I'm going to show him to you in a little bit. Next, we have Triple Accelerator. This card is the floater of the deck. You can use this to pretty much enhance your plays by special summoning this when you have a Geargia monster on the field. And then, in addition to that, if he leaves the board, you're able to actually just add a Geargia monster from your grave to your hand. Keep in mind that he can miss timing, so don't forget that. But he's really, really cool because if you have multiples of this in your hand, you can simply just plop them all down. When you have a Geargia monster, you can use that armor to get yourself an accelerator, special summon the accelerator, and then you can overlay them both for a Geargeigan X, aka Optimus Prime, and then get yourself more free pluses. For the level 3s, we run 3 Geargiano MK2 as well as 1 Geargiano. These guys are pretty cool. Geargia gear is actually at 3 now. It was at 1 for quite a while, but for a while it's also been at 3, so I thought it'd be kind of a cool opportunity to take advantage of that and play the Geargiano package. This is typically the most ideal ratio. When these guys are normal or flip summoned, you're able to special summon a Geargia monster from your hand or grave in face-up defense, and then when he's on your field, you can actually tribute him to target a level 4 machine type monster in your grave, and then special summon it, but its effects are negated. So you can use these guys in conjunction with the trap card of this deck called Geargia Gear, which allows you to summon Geargiano monsters from your deck and increase their levels by 1, so essentially they become level 4 monsters, which is really cool because then you can just instantly use them to make Geargeigan X, and it helps you do a lot more aggressive plays. But what's cool is these guys can also help you make a rank 3. You can make Break Sword with them, and they just help you stay in the game much longer and get into your Geargeigan X much faster. So Geargiano is really cool. There's some cool plays you can do with it and Geargia Accelerator. If you have either one of these, it's basically an infinite loop in the sense that if your opponent kills your Geargia Accelerator, you can add something back, and then if you have Geargiano in your hand or in your grave, you can use the Accelerator to add back that Geargiano, summon the Geargiano, tribute it, special summon back that Accelerator. If they destroy it, you can add back that Geargiano, and then just keep doing it over and over and over. It's not a very popular play anymore, just because it was much more popular when this deck was better, just because it was a play that could come up when you were in those grind games. Unfortunately, Yu-Gi-Oh! Isn't as much about grinding anymore, so it's not the best play you could do, but it is a play that you could do nonetheless. And what's cool about these guys is you can actually add these guys back with Geargeigan X, which allows you, when it leaves the board, to add a Geargiano monster back. So it's pretty cool. And then the remainder of the monsters, I actually run double Kaijus. I run 1 Cumungus and 1 Gamma Seal. I run 1 and 1 for a very odd reason. You can run, you know, the same ones if you'd like. I'm running these just because Gamma Seal is the smallest and Cumungus is the second smallest. I didn't want to run the same ones on the off chance that I draw both of them. If I draw both of them, I can give my opponent the Gamma Seal and summon myself the Cumungus. And because he's actually Earth, I can actually use him to make a Mrs. Radiant. So that's actually relevant for Link summoning. It doesn't come up often, but it's just there when you need it. And then the final monsters I use are 3 Ash Blossoms and 1 Maxi. These are just pretty staple hand traps for the deck. For the spells, I use 3 Pot of Desires just to turbo through everything. Traditionally, this deck would run cards like Upstart Goblin, but I didn't really want to play Upstart. I'm just playing Desires just to turbo through the deck. You kind of really need 3 Desires in a deck like this because this deck, it's a deck that requires you to set face down monsters such as Geargia Armor. So it means even if you're going first, it's like you're going second because you don't really do anything real on your first turn. And if you go second with this deck, it's almost like you're going fourth because you can't really do anything on your first turn. So Desires allows you to kind of expedite that process and get into some of your combo pieces a little bit easier. Much like my Yosenju deck, I'm trying out Quiet Life in this deck. It's a continuous spell. I did a recent video on it, and I used it in my Yosenju deck profile. It basically is a floodgate, which you have to activate at the start of your main phase 1 if you have no monsters. And it basically says, for both players, if you normal summon that turn, you can't special summon. If you special summon, you can't normal summon that turn. So your opponent's going to have to pick their poison. With a deck like this, it's not very difficult because most of the time you're normal summoning your armor until you can start special summoning. And usually then, once you have your accelerators in your hand, you don't really need to normal summon that same turn because you can just keep flipping up and face down for your armor if you still have one on the board. And it's just not necessary. So a card like this can actually inhibit your opponent. You can also play lose one turn in this deck to kind of make this a little bit more powerful. I just didn't have room for it. I'm actually at 41 cards in this deck list. So I didn't really want to go above that. I would probably even cut it down to 40 if possible. You can probably cut out one of the Desires if you really want to make it 40. But I just like Desires a lot. So double Quiet Life. It's a really cool floodgate. I'm just trying it out. It's something you guys can take out if you don't like it. Some board wipes I'm using are Regek and Dark Hole. And then the final spell I'm utilizing is 1 Soul Charge. This card has always been really good in a deck like this, especially with Geargia gear in general and just all the monsters you can put into the grave. You're able to pretty much make full use of Soul Charge and put all your monsters on the field, make some cool links, some XYZs, and keep a monster potentially on the field like armor and just keep flipping it up and face down if your opponent answered it earlier on the turn. So Soul Charge, very, very important. The all-star trap of the deck is 3 Geargia gears. Like I said earlier, you're allowed to activate this card once per turn, but it allows you to special summon 2 Gigiano monsters from your deck, and you increase their levels by 1. So you can either summon a combination of Gigiano and then Gigiano MK2, or you can just summon 2 of these guys, and then they become level 4. So you can XYZ for a 4, such as Gigiagon X, or any of your other rank 4 XYZs. So Geargia Gear is really, really cool. It used to be one of the most powerful traps in the game because you could simply set it, and during your opponent's end phase, you could simply activate this card, get yourself 2 monsters, and then just be on your way. And even if you drew multiples of this, and let's say you didn't draw any of your Geargianos, you'd really be in a fantastic position. The one downside to a card like this, though, is that because that Gusto Emerald is currently banned, you're not going to be able to loop them in your deck, so you're not really going to be able to make this card as live as you once were if you happen to draw, if you happen to see 3 of those monsters before you see any of these. So it's a little bit unfortunate, but Degusto Emerald, rest in pepperonis. he had his time with a deck like this. 3-dimensional barriers just to out Pendulum Magicians, ABCs, and Invoked. You can call Fusions, and really just any other deck out there that relies on the extra deck. This deck pretty much relies on your normal summon and XYZs. So this card, it doesn't really hurt you even if you activate this, because most of the time you can just sit on your normal summon monsters. I run 3 Solemn Strikes and 1 Solemn Warning just for some defense and counter trap removal for my opponent's cards. And then finally, I use 1 Torrential Tribute, which traditionally wasn't always the most popular card in this particular deck because you tend to be setting a lot, but I find in a deck like this, you really want to have a lot of board wipes, and that's why I use this, because let's say you don't even have to set it. You can use Accelerator with this. You can use Geargigant with this to basically protect it or to get a free card off of it and destroy your opponent's board and disrupt their plays. So this is actually my 41st card in the deck. So Torrential Tribute, pretty solid. That is the main deck. I'll go into the extra deck right now. The extra deck, I use 3 Geargigan X. This is Optimus Prime, as I call him. Optimus Prime is really, really cool. So essentially he requires 2 level 4 machine type monsters, And once per turn, you're able to detach a material from him to search a level 4 lower machine type monster from your deck. Or you can add one back from the grave to your hand, and then when he leaves the field, you're able to target a level 3 or lower Geargia monster in your grave and special summon that target. So you can summon back your Geargiano monsters onto the field with him, which is really, really cool. Especially Geargiano, like I said earlier, you're able to loop him with your accelerator if you use your accelerator to make them. So it's pretty cool. I like him a lot. You can basically just use him to attack. His stats are a little bit underwhelming now. 2300 isn't the strongest attack type monster, but overall, he's pretty much the main monster you want to be going into as frequently as possible. We use one Baguska, lock out the opponent, brand new XYZ monster from Circuit Break, really, really powerful. One Abyss Dweller for Dracos, now that they're probably going to be a little bit more popular again. Tornado Dragon, Dracos, as well as Magicians, and pretty much just anything else that relies on back rows, such as Paleozoics. One Castell, pretty much just a versatile generic rank 4, and then the Utopia package of Utopia 39, and then Utopia the Lightning. Pretty important out masterpiece. And then the final XYZ I use is one, the Phantom Knights of Breaksword. You can use a Mechwhip Dengeneer if you'd like, or any other rank 3. I just choose to use him because I'm not using Diamond Dyer in this extra deck. I don't really have room for it. So I'm just using Breaksword because it essentially accomplishes the same purpose. And you could make use of your Geargiano MK2s as well as your Geargiano if you happen to draw either of these, because you can just simply summon an MK2 and summon a Geargiano from your hand or grave, and then you can also summon himself, you know, one of the other monster copies of him from the grave or hand, and then just make break swords. So it's pretty cool. For links, I use one Mysis Radiant. All your monsters are Earth, pretty much, that you're going to be normal summoning. All the Geargia monsters are actually Earth-type monsters, which is pretty cool. So you can make Mrs. Radiant, and as a result of that, you can access more of the cards in your extra deck. And if it leaves, it basically is a Geargigan X for you in a lot of ways. So it's pretty cool. One Proxy Dragon and one Akshik Magician. I was actually considering trying Grinder Golem in this deck, but it didn't really work out well. I'm probably going to try that out once Security Dragon and I believe Code Talker come out, if I'm not mistaken. Those are the card names, because they make some of the combos you could do with this pretty cool, especially with Grinder Golem being as degenerate as it is with Link Summons. So Akshik Magician, it's not as good without those pieces. I know I'm not playing Grinder Golem in here. I just chose not to because I don't think it's as good without the rest of the cards. And you can still make use of her because you can simply just summon her and then bounce cards. So you can, you know, either bounce your own cards or bounce your opponent's cards with her that you otherwise wouldn't be able to deal with. So I really like her a lot. She's a pretty unique monster. One Decode Talker. You don't go into him frequently, but you can with your Geargia. And then finally, Borlo Dragon. You can actually go into him quite easily with cards like Soul Charge, Geargia, as well as MK2s. You can pretty much spam the board quite easily, and he's a win condition, so I really, really like him. You can also try the engine in the deck for the main deck. You can also try the, not the Gem Knight engine, excuse me, the Brilliant Fusion engine. It's pretty solid in this deck. It allows you to have an extra normal summon for the turn, which isn't terrible. It's just it takes up 5 cards in your main deck and 1 card in the extra deck, so that's probably the predominant reason why I didn't want to end up using it, as well as I said earlier, you know, with Akshik Magician and the Grinder Golem stuff, in the future I could definitely see this deck having some other cool nifty plays that you could do. But that's it for the main deck and the extra deck. I'll flip through the main deck one final time. The extra deck, as I said, you have some flexibility, you have some options with it, but ultimately it is a deck that plays relatively slowly in terms of its playstyle. It's a deck that you really just want to be patient with. You want to be setting your monsters, and you want to be sure that you're not really messing up with a deck like this, because there's a lot of risk versus reward plays in a deck like this, just because you can lose quite easily. Obviously, every other deck tends to be faster. Quiet Life is definitely one of the highlights of the deck. You should probably also try lose one turn if you'd like in a deck like this. I just didn't have the room for it, which is why I didn't want to try it out in here, but it's something you guys can definitely give a shot. If you guys have seen my other deck profiles, you guys know I like rogue decks like these, just because you know, I like them when they were, you know, some of the top decks in the meta, and I still like to build them every now and again when they are far past their prime, just because it's something I enjoy and it's a passion of mine. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys enjoyed it, please make sure to smash that like button, make sure to share this video with your friends, and make sure to become part of the Baby Dragon Squad by clicking that subscribe button and that notification bell, so you guys can be part of that notification squad to see my videos as soon as they're posted. Finally, also make sure you guys are checking out any other links that I post in the description. I tend to have lots of giveaways, and then make sure you guys check out my Patreon. You guys can become a patron. It would mean a lot to me. You guys can continue to help me sustain my channel growth and my channel videos so I can post daily videos for you guys. Without you guys, this would not be possible. So I hope you guys appreciate all the hard work and effort I do this, because obviously I do this at my own expense, And it's something that I really want to do for the foreseeable future. So thank you all so much for supporting my videos. I'll see you duels next time. Take it easy, my friends. And I'll see you guys tomorrow with another awesome video. I hope you guys enjoyed this Geargia deck profile for the November 2017 Forbidden Unlimited list. I'll see you guys next time. See you, baby Dragon Squad. And always remember, duelists, to believe in the heart of the cards.